This is an OSFP, so is this, and so is this. The differences are fin top, closed top, and riding heatsink. If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. The OSFP transceiver form factor has been around for quite some time now. As a matter of fact, the initial revision of the OSFP MSA specification was released in March 2017. And that was actually only 6 months after the initial revision of the MSA specification for the QSFP DD. Now, both these transceiver form factors were designed for 400 gig, both using 8 electrical lanes, each at 56 gig. But due to the smaller form factor and the lower power requirements, the QSFP DD actually became the more dominant form factor for 400 gig. But with 800 gig, the situation changed because the power requirements for 800 gig was considerably higher, making OSFP the more suitable form factor. Since the OSFP transceiver form factor was designed to handle higher power consumption, so we're talking 20 watts or higher, an optimized thermal design was required. And the result was the fintop design, or to be more precise, the open fintop design and the closed fintop design. Now, both of these were described in the original MSA specification. And as you can see, mechanically speaking, they are compatible to each other. So in other words, you can slot either one of these into the OSFP port. However, since the thermal characteristics of both of these designs are slightly different, it is still important to check with the equipment manufacturer which fintop design they recommend for which equipment. NVIDIA, for example, states that the closed-top design can only be used in switches with reverse airflow configuration. Okay, so now we've talked about the fintop OSFP design, but what about the OSFPs that don't have any fins at all? Well, as I mentioned beforehand, the fintop design is ideally suited for the high power scenarios. So in other words, when we're talking about 800 gig switches. However, the equipment manufacturers still wanted to use the OSFP form factor, but in 400 gig scenarios with lower power requirements, but with space constraints. To be more precise, they also wanted to use OSFP for their NICs, so network interface cards, or for example, the DPUs, so the data processing units. And that is then where the design without any fins comes into play. Let me explain. Beginning of 2019, the revision 2.0 of the OSFP MSA specification was released. And in that revision 2.0, we then had the specification for the riding heatsink, or short RHS design of the OSFP. In other words, this design with no fins at all. And since there aren't any fins included in the transceiver, the cooling of the transceiver had to be taken care of externally. And that is then done here. You can see the transceiver cage itself is open to the top, and then on top of that is a spring-loaded heatsink. The advantage of this design was that alternatively to a spring-loaded heatsink, it was also possible to use liquid cooling. Now, from a mechanical point of view, it is actually quite obvious that it's not possible to slot a fintop transceiver into a transceiver slot designed for the RHS. But of course, it is possible the other way around. But since we don't have the cooling, the proper cooling for this RHS design in a fintop transceiver cage, that had to be prevented. And that is actually done here. As you can see, the back design of the RHS is slightly different, and this slight difference actually will prevent the connectors of the riding heatsink transceiver connecting into the slot of the fintop transceivers properly, and therefore it wouldn't start. Okay, so in short, we've got three OSFP designs. We've got the fintop, we've got the closed top, and also we've got the RHS or riding heatsink design. And this RHS design actually a lot of times is also referred to as the flat top. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel so that you get your regular dose of brain snacks. Until next time, bye-bye.